Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Can I invite each and everyone to please stand up and welcome the word of the Lord? Hallelujah, Lord. If you have your Bibles with you, kindly please open them in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verses 14 up until 16. This is the word of the Lord. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves down and pray and seek my face and turn away from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Now my eyes will be open and my ears attentive to the prayers offered in this place. I have chosen and consecrated this temple so that my name may be there forever. My eyes and my heart will always be there. The word of the Lord. Let us pray. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, thank you so much, O Lord God, for all your goodness. Nagpapasalamat kami, Panginoon, sa lahat ng iyong kabutihan. Sa lahat, Father God, ng iyong ipinakita, at mas lalo na, Panginoon, sa mga bagay na hindi namin nakikita. Dahil alam namin, Father God, that there is even a greater need. There is even a bigger battle happening, Father God, in the spiritual realm. And we thank you so much because we are always safe and protected in your hands. Father, maraming salamat sa araw na to, sa iyong pagkakatipon sa aming lahat. To all the people who are gathering here in this place, in your temple, as well as to those people who are joining us online, Father God, whether they may be in the country or they may be overseas. Maraming salamat. And Lord, corporately, we are expectant, we are excited of the outpouring that you are going to pour out upon your people today. And Lord, we entrust your words unto you. Bless it. Sanctify it. Let it not return to you void, empty, and powerless, but rather, Lord, in our hearts, in our life, as we revere you as Lord, Lord, let it be done unto us according to your words. And Father, give us that receptive spirit. Give us that receptive heart, Father God, in order to receive your words with joy, with gladness, and with thanksgiving in our heart. But give us, Lord, that duty to go away and meditate on your words to make sure, Father, that it is what you say it is, Father God. And Lord, I pray, anuman po, Father God, yung battle, anuman yung situation, circumstances na pinagdadaanan ng bawat isa. Panginoon, I pray, O Lord God, na ikaw yung magpunas, ikaw yung magliwanag, Panginoon. Anuman yung hindi kayang i-give up, Father God. Lord, we pray. We pray, Father, that with your grace and mercy, ikaw ang mananahan sa buhay, sa isip, sa puso ng bawat isa. Maraming salamat, Lord, as for your servant. Nagpapatuloy po akong nagpapakumbaba sa iyo. Nagpapatuloy po akong nagpapasakop sa iyo, Panginoon. And Lord, I pray na wala po ni katiting sa akin ang makita at marinig kung hindi tanging ikaw lamang po, Panginoon. Ikaw lamang ang maitaas. Ikaw lamang ang mapapurihan. Ikaw lamang ang maigloria. Ito po ang aming samot dalangin sa pangalan ng iyong anak na si Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Palakpakan nga po natin ang Panginoon, mga kapatid. Hallelujah. You deserve the praises and you deserve all the glory. Amen, mga kapatid. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Kung napansin niyo po, mga kapatid, no? Yung team po natin ngayong Sunday sa praise and worship, and for this Sunday's message is about revival. Amen. And sometimes we appreciate people, no, kung nakatalaga silang magpapakanta and they gave the pastor a ring or they asked the pastor, ano po ang team nitong Sunday ito? Kasi that's how service is should be like, mga kapatid, no? It's a seamless worship, no? But this time, although hindi po kami nag-usap ni Sister Michelle, but the Lord is working. Amen? The Lord is working. Kung napansin nyo po, it's the time, no? The theme of this Sunday is about revival. This is the theme that the Lord have imparted to His servants, kay Sister Michelle at sa buhay ng inyong lingkod, no? So, Sister Michelle, please share to us briefly, what was the conversation with the Lord? What was the revelation of the Lord that led us sa ating lineup this Sunday? Ano ba ang any particular burden, any particular na revelation?
Actually po, this lineup has already been prepared for last Sunday po dapat yun. Siguro inilalagay po sa akin ng Panginoon sa puso ko yung nangyayari. Nakikita naman po natin kung ano yung nangyayari. But we have been praying for breakthrough for this church. We've been praying for revival. Amen. Sa bawat isa. And as I was reading up and meditating on that Second Chronicles, doon po nag-strike sa akin yung verse 15, Pastor, na then yung sinabi niya na pakikinggan ko. Bubuksan ko yung aking mga mata, my eyes, I will open my eyes and open my ears sa panalangin na siyang gagawin nyo sa lugar na ito. So, doon, yun po yung nag-ano sa akin, yung revival, we have been praying for it. Hindi lang po siguro sa church, even sa sarili ko, na dahil alam ko po na I have not been doing yung calling na binigay sa akin ng Panginoon. And I have been praying for a breakthrough also in my life, a revival to my service sa Panginoon, yung relationship ko po sa Kanya. So, that was yung binigay po sa akin ng Panginoon. So, amen po.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord, and may the Lord God bless you, no? It is a commendable, it's an act of humility and humbleness, and it's an act of surrender sa Panginoon for one to recognize na kailangan ko ang revival, di ba? Especially siguro sa atin na tumatayo sa harap. Sometimes siguro to admit in ourselves that we need a revival is we seem to be exposing ourselves, diba? Pero mga kapatid, I agree with you, dear sister, and I believe that all of us can agree with Sister Michelle, and all of us can attest to that, mga kapatid. And I, for one second, that motion that I need revival. Amen. Does anyone of us in here who are in need of revival as well? Amen. As a declaration of surrender and declaration na we recognize that, are we able to raise our hands? Amen. And if you are online, I guess yung mga hindi nag-raise ng hands, hindi sila nangangailangan ng revival. Maraming salamat. Amen. Glory to the Lord na hindi natin kailangan ng revival. Amen. And if you are online, I know and I do believe that people online is in need of revival as well. Lahat po tayo, mga kapatid, ay nangangailangan ng revival. All of us, mga kapatid, ay nangangailangan ng revival. Personally, our homes, our family, at work, even this very church. Sabi nga ni Sister Michelle, hindi lang itong church na to. Amen. If we go and sit down with the Aldershot churches together, each and every church has their fair bit of share of concerns and alarms. So that is just a fraction. That is only Aldershot. How much more the churches in Alton? How much more the churches in Borden? Churches in Basingstoke? How much more all the churches? How many churches are there in Hampshire? How many churches are there in each and every county of this UK? How many churches are there in Europe and all the rest of the five continents of the world? All of us, my dear brothers and sisters, are in need of revival. Amen? Kung meron pong hindi nangangailangan ng revival, please share us the secret. This nation is in need revival. This world is in need a revival, mga kapatid. And although siguro the world leaders result into war to cause revival, although the world leaders perhaps will result into their riches, into their funds to cause revival, but there is nothing else that can cause revival. No amount of world power, no amount of war can bring revival. Not even economic boom. Kung merong prime minister, kung mayroong leader dyan na may sikreto, kung maibalik uli ang kabaliktaran ng pananamlay, yung pagsigla ng ekonomiya, I don't think that will cause revival. No election can bring revival. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. Because revival is a sovereign work of our Almighty God. Tanging Panginoon lamang ang makakapagbigay ng revival. Amen, church? Gusto po ba natin ng revival? Do we want revival? Kasi kung babasahin natin yung 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse, kung yung 13, sabihin natin, that the heavens were shut up, and there is no rain, and there are locusts all around devouring the land, and there are plagues that were sent to oppress the people. Have you looked at that situation? If you are living in that life situation before, my dear brothers and sisters, you will need one thing and one thing only, and that is revival. Amen. And revival is a sovereign work of our Lord Almighty. That's the reason why the Lord shared to us the secret to a revival. If my people, it says in there, who are called by my name. Amen. The Lord, partida. The Lord is not even talking about the unbelievers. The Lord, in this world, I don't think that it's half-half. Siguro one-third of this world population are believers. Siguro two-thirds are unbelievers. And the Lord is not even talking to the two-thirds. The Lord is talking to the one-third. The Lord is talking to the believers. The Lord is talking to His people. Sa mga tao po niya. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Amen. The Lord is looking for intercessors. The Lord is looking for intercessors that will intercede. Mga kapatid, And in lieu of these intercessors, the Lord will not only heal the intercessor's sin, the Lord will not only prosper the land where the intercessors live. No! The Lord will heal all the land, including the land that was inhabited by the remaining two-thirds, which are non-believers, which are sinners, mga kapatid. Amen. So mga kapatid, bilang tinawag ng Panginoon, bilang lingkod ng Panginoon, at nakikita natin mga kapatid ang nangyayari sa kapaligiran. Huwag tayong malungkot, huwag tayong malumbay. Mga kapatid, because tinawag tayo ng Panginoon. Amen. Tinawag tayo ng Panginoon. Tinawag tayo ng Panginoon to humble down and intercede. Ano yung sabi niya sa 15? My eyes will be open and my ears attentive to the prayers offered in this place. Where is in this place at the moment? This is our Shechem. Amen, church? This is where the Lord gave the promise. This is where the Lord showed His good countenance. I have chosen and consecrated this temple so that my name may be there forever. My eyes and my heart will always be there. Mga kapatid, in the life of these children, pay attention. Even the life of this adult, even the life of your elders will expire. It does not diminish the power of God. Because the power of God is in you, in the next generation after you, provided that the Lord will not yet return. Because sabi niya rito mga kapatid, I have chosen and consecrated this temple so that my name be there forever. My eyes and my heart will always be there. Amen. And this is yung commitment ko sa Panginoon. People and personality might come and go. People and personality might expire. But this church, Christ is our Rock Church Ministries, will supersede life of people. Christ is our Rock Church is not dependent in our shoulders, whoever you are. It's dependent in the Lord. People and life may expire and go, but the promise of the Lord will remain. And the promise of the Lord will always be carried forth and continued forth by this church and by this ministry. That's what the Lord has called us forth to do. So mga kapatid, though we are few, we are surrounded by many. David said, I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than spend it elsewhere. I would rather come and stand here on myself and worship the name of the Lord than be in Gun Wharf, than be in Basingstoke. Mga kapatid. Amen po. So mga kapatid, all of us are in need of revival. And ano po yung sabi ng Panginoon? Jeremiah 33 verse 3, remind ourselves, ano yung sabi ng Panginoon doon? Call unto me, and I will listen to you. Amen. And I will reveal to you great and mighty things. Lord, we desire revival. Ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? I will answer you. I will answer you with revival. Great and mighty things is an act of breakthrough. Amen po. Alam nyo mga kapatid, We were talking about Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Nasabi nga natin, sabi ng Panginoon kay Jeremiah, "Call unto me and I will answer you, and I will tell you great and mighty things." Ano yung sabi natin? Alam nyo mga kapatid, Jeremiah was the prophet during the time of exile. Jeremiah was the prophet during the time when the Babylonians carried the Israelites into captivity. Sister Michelle was talking about the captivity last Friday, about the life of the prophet Daniel. But let us not forget that Daniel and Ezekiel, they were written on exile. Amen? But the prophet Jeremiah wrote, or the prophet Jeremiah prophesied about the exile. Amen? So Jeremiah was the one who prophesied that exile is coming. Amen. Jeremiah wrote before the exile and during the exile. Amen po. So makikita natin dito mga kapatid that the people of Israel were carried into captivity by the Babylonians. Amen. And when the Babylonians came and carried the people of Israel into captivity, what have they done? They have destroyed the temple. Amen. The very same temple that the Lord says, "In this place I have consecrated my name." Amen. And mga kapatid, it is the very same temple na ibinigay ng Panginoon ng kanyang pangako. It is the very same place na ibinigay ng Panginoon ng kanyang pangako. And few years after, the Babylonians came and they ransacked that very temple where God gave the promise. You could imagine, ano po yung pakiramdam ng mga tao? The temple of God, the work of the Lord, is in disrepair. People were taken into captivity, the choice people, yung mga piling people, katulad ni na Daniel and all those choice people. But some of the remnants remain in the land. And the temple was destroyed. The temple was in disrepair. Just imagine, ano po yung pakiramdam ng mga tao, mga kapatid? They are feeling depressed. Amen? They are feeling depressed, mga kapatid. His people was dispirited. No, it's as if the spirit left them. Pero alam niyo po ba na ganun yung nangyayari sa buhay ng mga Kristiyano ngayon? Ganun yung nangyayari sa buhay ng mga simbahan ngayon, mga kapatid. The church, the believers, has been carried in exile by the captivity of this world. The world has exchanged the word of God into a lie. Church has become compromising. Church has become negotiable, sabi ni Sister Michelle last Friday. And so the believers that form parts of the church, our friends, our brothers and sisters in faith, the Church of England. So, meron silang request. I will give us an email, mga kapatid. And if you can, use your individual email and just email that email individually and say that we support your stand. Because this is the email of the bishop that is responsible in this area. Because on February, all the bishops will come and vote whether they will permit same-sex marriage in the church or they will not. Akala ko ba salita ng Panginoon? Bakit kailangang makarating dun? Bakit kailangang pagbutuhan ng tao? Why can't we not just simply uphold the word of God? Dahil the church, the believers, have been in captivity by the world. The church And the believers, my dear brothers and sisters, have been captivated by the desires of the flesh. The church and the believers have been in captivity by the works and wiles and the schemes of the enemy. Christians are compromising. The churches are, ano yung sabi ni Sister Michelle? Negotiable. Amen. But still, many of us hope for a revival. Amen, church. Many of us are crying and desiring for a revival. Is that an accurate statement? Amen. Are we hoping? Are we praying? Are we desiring for a revival, mga kapatid? Amen. I'm gonna tell you this. And I hope and I pray that this is me not talking on my own emotion, but I hope and I pray that this is the word of the Lord. And I'm gonna tell you this. That a revival in this church is not only possible, but it is inevitable if we inline ourselves with the will of the Lord. Amen po. Revival is inevitable if we inline ourselves, if we inline our heart, if we inline our lives in the will of the Lord. Amen, church? Amen? Bakit po walang revival? Why is there no revival? Is it because the believers, the Christians are secular now? Napaka-liberal na natin? Katulad niyan, yung principle, yung practices ng mundo ay pinagsasama na natin sa practices ng simbahan. It's a very liberal, napaka-liberal na natin. Tingnan natin ang mga tao, mga kabataan ngayon, they are very liberal. Is that the reason why the walang nangyayaring revival? Is that because there is disunity in the church? Is it because there is infighting within the church? Is it the church now has become worldly? Is it the church now become compromised? And is it the church now becomes negotiable? Is that the reason why na walang nangyayaring revival? I believe that that's not the reason. Dahil maski baguhin nating lahat yon, I believe na revival still will not come. Dahil I believe that these are not the cause of revival. These are the result of no revival. Amen. These are the result of no revival and other worse scenarios, mga kapatid. Amen. Because sabi nga natin, that revival is the result of God showing Himself. Diba ito yung sabi niya rito, mga kapatid? Oh? If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. Amen. Revival, my dear brothers and sisters, is when God will come down. Is will God will enter into a situation. When God will get involved into a picture. Yun po yung result ng revival. Amen po. What is revival? Revival is when God comes down. When God's glory is being revealed. When God allows His people to encounter and experience Him, yung true encounter and yung true experience, ah, hindi yung encounter as an outburst of our emotion. Isaiah 64:1, it says in there, "Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down." Diba? It's a parallel dito sa 2 Chronicles. That I would tear open in heavens and I will come down, that the mountains would quake at my presence. That is what revival is, mga kapatid. Kung ang presensya ng Panginoon ay bumababa. And that presence, mga kapatid, the Lord coming down, mga kapatid, ano po yan? That is an outcome of our constant desire to meet and to have an appointment with God. Amen. Kailan po bababa ang Panginoon? Kailan po magkakaroon ng revival? Mga kapatid, revival ay bunga ng ating constant, tuloy-tuloy na kalooban, kagustuhan, pagtawag, pakikipag-appointment sa Panginoon. If my people who are called by my name, sabi niya rito, will humble themselves down and pray and seek my face. Amen. So mga kapatid, ibig sabihin there is no revival because we are not constant. There is no revival because we are not pressing. We are not consistent in our desire to meet and have appointment with God. Sige po, for discussion's sake, for the sake of opinion, sabihin natin, we regularly seek God. But correct me if I'm wrong. Most of the time, mga kapatid, we seek God because we want Him to do something in our lives. We seek God because we want Him to do something for our family. We seek God because we want Him to do something for our church. We seek God because we want Him to do something for other people. We seek God because we want something to do for our nation. We seek God because we want Him to do something for this world. So ibig sabihin, mga kapatid, we are seeking the hands in the power of God. Amen. And we are not seeking His face. Amen po, mga kapatid. Ang sabi ng Panginoon, mga kapatid, is seek His face. Seek His presence. Seek His glory. Amen. That our heart should yearn for Him. Amen po, mga kapatid. Lahat po tayo gusto po nating makatuntong sa langit, di po ba? Amen? Ang sabi ng Panginoong Hesukristo, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Amen po, mga kapatid. Papaano kung magising ka ng isang araw and sabihin sa'yo, for today in one day only, there is an opportunity to go to heaven, to be in heaven without accepting the Lord Jesus Christ. Will you do that? Hindi. Because my dear brothers and sisters, the very essence there is not going to heaven. The very essence there is to build up a relationship with Christ. Amen, church. Being in heaven is just a fruits of that relationship. Amen po. So the same thing that, mga kapatid, would revival be enjoyable? Would revival be sustained? Would revival be, mga kapatid, malalasap ba natin yung nanam at tamis ng revival if that revival came not because of seeking the Lord? If that revival came because of our own strength, if that revival came because of our own talent and skills and ability, my heart, our heart needs to yearn for the Lord. Amen po. Our heart needs to yearn for God. We should be saying that, God, come down. And when we do that, mga kapatid, love to come down. Jeremiah 33:3. If you ask me to come down, I will come down. And I will show you great and mighty things. Exodus chapter 3 verses 7 to 10. The Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying out because of their slave drivers. And I am concerned about their suffering. So I have come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptian, to bring them up out into the land, into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey, the home of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. And now the cry of the Israelites have reached me, and I have seen the way the Egyptians have oppressed them. So now, go, I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. My dear brothers and sisters, for 400 years, Israelites were in slavery in Egypt. For 400 years, and in their captivity, mga kapatid, revival became inevitable when they began crying to the Lord. Amen. When they began crying to the Lord, when they began calling upon the name of the Lord, history would tell us, mga kapatid, that in the beginning of their oppression, in their captivity, they trust in their own capability. Punong-puno pa rin sila, mga kapatid, the history about Joseph. And they still believe that another Joseph will come. And they forgot that Joseph was only able to manifest what he has manifested because of the Lord. So nakalimot po sila sa Panginoon. But the moment that they began calling the Lord, that the moment that they began crying to the Lord sent Moses, and Moses said, I have heard the cry of my people in Egypt. So now I have come down. Amen po. So do we really want to see revival? Do we really want to see revival? Amos chapter 3 verse 3, it says in there, do two walk together unless they have agreed to do so. Makakapagtrabaho po ba ang dalawa unless they agreed to do so? Makakalakad po ba ang dalawa unless they agreed to do so? Mga kapatid, in order for you to get here to there, your both legs will have be in agreement to walk. Kung yung kanan lang ang maglalakad at yung kaliwa ay ayaw lumakad, can you reach there? Same with your hands. Makakapalakpak ba ang kamay na isang kamay lang? Makakapalakpak ba ang kamay na yung right lang ang magdi-desire ng papalakpak? Hindi. The same thing with revival, mga kapatid. Can revival happen without agreement? Mangyayari po ba ang revival without agreement? Mga kapatid, God is our omnipresent God. God will never be late. God will never fail to turn up. Alam niyo po kung bakit? Because He is omnipresent God. He is constantly there. Hindi niya po kailangang manggaling somewhere else, mga kapatid. Amen po. Tayo po yung hindi nagte-turn up sa ating appointment. Tayo po yung nali-late sa ating appointment. Tayo po yung hindi nagpapakita sa ating appointment. In Genesis chapter 3 verses 8 to 9, it says in here, they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But God, the Lord, called to the man and said to him, Adam, where are you? So nakikita niyo po rito, mga kapatid, the story is, Adam and Eve had an appointment with God regularly, every day, in the Garden of Eden. The Lord would show up in the cool of the day, and He would walk with His friends. Amen? He would walk with His friends. Of course, hindi po natin alam in what form did the Lord take, but alam natin that What a wonderful time would it had been. What a marvelous time would it had been if you are with the Lord. Amen. Irregardless of how the Lord will show up to you, irregardless of a conviction, irregardless of a word, irregardless of a passage in the Bible, irregardless that you will be slain in cry, irregardless that the Lord will give you a song in your heart, whatever it is that the Lord used to turn up in your appointment, mga kapatid, I know that it would be a wonderful time. Amen, church? Up until one day, Adam did not turn up. Adam did not show up to his appointment with God. Because Adam sinned. So God said, Adam, where are you? Hinanap niya si Adan. Mga kapatid, sabihin niyo sa akin to. Is God all-knowing? The moment that Adam and Eve sinned, alam ba ng Panginoon yun? Before nahanapin niya si Adan na, Adam, where are you? Did the Lord knew that they sinned? Amen. Mga kapatid, the irony is this. The Lord have an appointment with Adam and Eve regularly in the Garden of Eden. Up until one day they sinned and they did not turn up to their appointment. Alam ng Panginoon na nagkasala sila. Pero ano yung sinabi ng Panginoon? Adam, I know you have sinned. Adam, I know you have failed me. But where are you? Mga kapatid, nagkakasala ka man ngayon. You probably might still be feeling down today. You probably might not be feeling the weather today. But Lord, the Lord is looking for you. The Lord is waiting for you. Our sin is not a reason not to make an appointment with God. Amen, church? Our luck is not a reason not to make an appointment with God. Hinahanap po ng Panginoon si Adan. Hinahanap po tayo ng Panginoon. Amen. Hinahanap po tayo ng Panginoon. Where are you? Why don't I hear from you? Why don't I see you in the church where my people gather to worship me? Why don't I see you in the TGIF fellowship? Why don't I see you in the Women's Wednesday? Why don't I see you in the Tuesday and Thursday prayer in devotion? Why don't I see you in Aldershot? Why are you not making an appointment with me? Why don't I hear your prayer? Why are you not praying to me? Why don't I see you reading the Bible? Why don't I see you meditating the Word? What is going on? Where are you? Hinahanap po tayo ng Panginoon, mga kapatid. Revival is when God will come down. Amen. In Amos chapter 3 verse 3, God will come down if we desire for it. God will come down if we agree with it. God will come down if we permit it. You know, yun yung irony ng Panginoon. The Lord is sovereign and the Lord is so powerful, but He will not force Himself to us. Amen, church? Kaya nga yung binasa nating 2 Chronicles kanina, mga kapatid, nakikita ng Panginoon, alam ng Panginoon yung estado ng Israel during that time, and alam ng Panginoon na ang sagot ay ang kanyang pagbaba, ang sagot ay ang kanyang pagdating, ang sagot ay ang ulan ng revival. But He did not enforce it. He asked the people to desire for it. He asked the people to want it. He asked the people to agree with it. He asked the people to permit it. Amen, mga kapatid. My dear brothers and sisters and people online, hindi ko po alam kung ano yung estado natin ngayon. Ikaw lamang at ang Panginoon po ang nakakaalam. Maybe, hindi tayo willing na ma-steer muli yung init ng ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon. Maybe sa mga panahong ito, ayaw nating i-steer yung passion natin. Siguro sa mga panahong ito, mas gusto nating maging subdue muna tayo. Mas gusto nating maging tahimik muna tayo. Mas gusto muna nating maging personal at sarilinin muna natin. Maybe sa mga panahong ito, we are still clothed with our rags of our own righteousness. Na gusto pa rin siguro nating, hindi, gusto ko pa rin gawin kung ano yung aking makakaya at aking magagawa, mamaya na ang Panginoon. Maybe we are still stuck in unnecessary controversies of life. Maybe we are still stuck where our faith is compromised and negotiable. Maybe we are still stuck where we are satisfied. Mga kapatid, there are graded progression in faith. You can be a personal Christian and the Lord will give you a personal revival if that's what you desire to the Lord. But as a servant, as a minister, if you desire a church revival, you need to now step up to where the church operates. Amen. Hindi ba hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na we desire church revival and say that, oh, it's a personal. No, personal is yourself. But if you step forward and if you offer yourself, mga kapatid, in the service of the Lord, then kailangan there is a graded progression. Amen. Maybe we are a drying leaf or a drying branches that needs to be grafted to the vine, mga kapatid. Hindi ko po alam kung ano ang sitwasyon ng bawat isa. But if we really need revival, if we really are hungry and thirsty of revival, if we really want revival, we need to begin making appointment with God. We need to begin making appointment with God. We need to begin seeking the glory of God. Hindi lamang po yung kamay at magagawa ng Panginoon. Naghihintay po ang Panginoon. He is excited, leaning in heaven, just waiting for us, mga kapatid, to desire for it. Waiting for us, mga kapatid, to permit Him, to allow Him, mga kapatid. Amen po. Waiting for us to call upon His name, and He will listen, and He will show us great and mighty things. Amen po. Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah. Sige po, tumayo po tayo, and we'll have our communion. Praise you, Jesus. And tawagin po natin yung ating mga music team. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sige po. Hallelujah. Sige. Mangyari na Ate Sister Annie. Sister Abilina, help us with our elements. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, partida pa yan, ha? Hallelujah, Lord. Okay pa. Praise you, Jesus. The word of the Lord says, therefore, whoever eats the bread or drink the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. And a man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself. At Father God, maraming salamat sa araw na to. Lord, even as the music team usher us in your glory. We desire, O God. We seek your face, Lord. And Lord, as they usher us, Father God, reveal to us, Father God, your glory. We humble ourselves down and we ask for your forgiveness for all the many multitudes of sins that we have committed. And Father God, we entrust unto you the life of your servants, our dear sister Annie, our dear sister Abelina. Father, give them a clean hands, give them a pure heart and a clear conscience and a spirit that as they hand, Lord, this element, it's as if we are receiving them from you. Lord, we entrust unto you this element, this drink that symbolizes your blood and this bread that symbolizes your body. Cleanse them, sanctify them in the raw form for the purposes that you have intended for us this afternoon. Cause it, Lord, that as we partake of them, that your presence, the fullness of your glory overflow in us. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. People online, please join us. Taas po natin ang ating tinapay. For we receive from the Lord what He also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you." Let's eat the bread. Hallelujah. Let's lift up the cup. In the same manner, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Let's drink the cup. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Sige, purihin po natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah, Lord.
To ang saro ng bagong tipan, inumin mo, makibahagi. Ang buong
Hallelujah. Sige po mga kapatid, people of God. Let's trust in the Lord. Let's trust in the power of communion, fulfilling in the completion of the perfect and finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ in the cross. Sige po mga kapatid, we all desire revival. People who are here and people who are online, sige po, we intercede. Ano man po yung personal revelation ng Panginoon, ano man po yung personal burden ng Panginoon na inilalagay sa ating puso, let's intercede po para sa Panginoon. Hallelujah. Sige po mga kapatid, sabay-sabay po tayo. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Father, restore your church. Restore your people, Father God. Purify your church. Purify your people, O God. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, we trust in the power of the cross. We trust in the victory that the cross brought, Lord. And we desire, we pray for a revival in this church and all the other churches, Father God. Revival in our community. Revival in our nation. Revival in the world, Father God. Lord, revival in our service to you. Revival in our passion, Father God. Revival in our maturity, Father God. Lord, revival in our commitment. Revival in our faith in you, Father God. Lord, we desire for that revival, Father God. We long for that revival, Father God. Help us to trust in you. Help us to trust in you. Help us to put our joy in you. Help us to put our comfort in you. Help us, Lord, to put meaning and reason in you, Father God. Lord, help us overcome where we have previously failed. Help us to overcome our soul, our emotion, and cling on to our spirit. Lord, let there be purity among your people. Let there be purity among all the families. Let there be purity, O God, upon this church, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Let every soul, let every mind, let every desire, O God, goes on desiring you. Goes on desiring you. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We pray as well for revival on that bishop's meeting, O God, on that February. We pray, Lord, that you raise up bishops to vote, to sustain your words, and not the clamor of this world, Father God. Father, let those bishops, Father God, who choose to uphold your word will not succumb to the pressure of this world, Father God. Let there be revival sa buhay ni Judy Isquera. For full, complete healing and deliverance, Father, from that brain damage, O God. Let there be healing and deliverance, Lord, upon the life of Rhea Urrea from that gangrenous leg. Full restoration of that leg, that life will spring out again from that leg, Father God. Healing and revival upon the life of Tony Manzano, Father God. Thank you that you're gonna restore his strength, his well-being, his life. Life and revival upon the life of Teresita Ledesma, Father God. Overcoming, O God, that dialysis, that diabetes, Father God. Full revival, Lord, for the life of the dad of Brother Alan, from that jaw, Father God, infection of the jaw. Thank you, Lord, that that is healed and delivered right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Healing and revival, Lord, sa buhay ni Sister Annie, Father God. For the eradication and total removal, O God, of that inactive and dormant situation, O God. Full and complete revival to the life of Emma Ortega, Father God, from that cancer. We rebuke that cancer right now. Full healing and revival upon the life of Andy, Father God, for that cancer. For Christine or Jane, for that cancer, Father God. And for the colleague of Sister Michelle, full and complete total healing and revival from that cancer. For the tumor in the lungs of the brother-in-law of Paul, Lord, full, complete, and total healing and revival upon the heart of these people. Father, to all the churches, including, Lord, to the lampstand, to the pastors, to the priests and the leaders of these churches, Lord, full revival, Father God. You know their situation, you know their predicaments, you know their condition, including their families. Father, be the source of revival to their needs, to their finances, to their situation. Many of whom, Father God, are planting churches, Father God, in far places, Lord, where their safety is compromised. Full revival to them, Father God, in Jesus' name. And Lord, kung may mga lingkod kang tumalikod sa'yo, kung may mga lingkod kang nagkasala katulad ni Adan, pangangalun niya, pagkakasala, Panginoon, Lord, restoration.
Restoration, Lord.
Tell them, where are you?
Yes, Lord.
Nasaan ka, anak? In Jesus' name. At Father God, kung may mga kapamilya po kami, may mga kakilala, kaibigan, who are grieving for the recent loss of a loved ones, Father, ikaw ang magsilbi at magpatuloy na kalakasan at comfort sa buhay ng bawat isa. And Lord, full and revival sa aming mga pamilya, sa bawat magulang, sa bawat kapatid, asawa, anak, pamangkin, apo, kamag-anak, Father God, na hindi pa nakakakilala sa iyo. Full and complete revival upon them, Father God, in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you as well for the power of your full and complete revival sa buhay ni Milky Vinluan Garcia or Mick Mick, Father God. Lord, we thank you because this week She is going to sit down on her LET exam. And Lord, thank you because sitting down on that LET exam is just a formality, Father God. Thank you because right here, right now, in this place, she has already passed that exam. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Receive it in faith. Receive it in power. Receive it in victory without doubt. Thank you, Lord, that that exam this week is just a formality. But Lord, you have given her already that LET registration. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And Lord, alalahanin mo po, Father God, ang mga mag-aaral namin, ang lahat ng mga bata na pumapasok. Lord, excel them in their classes. Ibigay mo yung wisdom, knowledge, and understanding sa kanila upang sa ganun ay mapagtagumpayan ang lahat, O Lord God, ng kanilang pinag-aaralan. At sa lahat ng workforce namin, lahat ng mga nagtratrabaho, mga magulang, mga kapatid who are working, Father God, give them a favorable week this week. Ibigay mo sa kanila, Lord, that they will always be the heads and not the tail on those workplaces, that they will command respect on those workplaces, that Father God, people will be subdued by the Spirit on this workplaces, Father God. And maraming maraming salamat, Father God, Lord, sa aming pagtatapos. Lord, katulad ng paghahanap mo kay Adan, Lord, we declare that calling out in the Spirit, in the air. Kapatid, nasaan ka? Brother, sister, where are you? Lord, we know and we do believe that you will continue to convict these people, your children, Father God, wherever they may be. Thank you so much, Father God. And sabay-sabay po nating banggitin, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you very much. May God bless you all and to the people online. Thank you for joining us. Up until next week, may God bless you all. Hallelujah.
Time's
refreshing.
Time's
refreshing the food.
Oh. Yes, it's time of refreshing. Comes from the Lord. Amen. Amen.
You give me life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon.
Happy birthday.
Declare a blessing sa ating lahat.
First of all po, I would like to thank the Lord for the new life na binigay niya and another year na binigay niya. Thank you for the last year na blessing, for all of the things that He has done for my life and for my family. And I want to thank the Lord for this family. The Sierra family na binigay niya. I want to thank the Lord for all of the provisions na binibigay niya to this ministry. In spite of all of the trials na pinagdadaanan ng ministry na ito, we know and we believe that all things works all things work for the good of the one who loves God. So there's a reason for everything. So we just need to trust in God. God bless you all po. Thank you for the presents and the card and the wishes. Thank you for all of my friends as well na nag-greet sa akin. Thank you po.
Amen. Okay, ipag-pray po natin ang ating kapatid. Let's extend our hands to Sister Annie. Hallelujah, most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father. Lord, thank you very much for the wonderful opportunity that all of us will be able to spend this joyous and wonderful moment to the life of our dear Sister Annie. And Lord, in one accord, we thank you so much for all your good countenance all the days of her life, Father God. And Lord, we thank you. We thank you because knowing and believing that however you have blessed her, Lord, that you will continue to bless her, Father God, over the years to come, Lord. Thank you for that promise, Father God, that you are making things brand new every morning for her life, O God. Thank you, Lord, for the message of revival, Father God, and thank you for the message of comfort that call unto me. And I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things. And thank you so much, Father God. We look forward and we amaze in awe for that great and mighty things that you will do upon the life of our Sister Annie. We thank you so much and we look forward for that great and mighty things that you are going to do in this church with Sister Annie. Be a participant, Father, and all of us here, Father God, her brothers and sisters in you, Lord. It truly indeed is a wonderful privilege to stand and worship you alongside her. We thank you for the life of her parents, for using them, Lord, and bringing her here. We thank you for all the lives of the people that you have showered her with, Father God. Amen. This is our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday po. Yeah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus.
Switch mo, Mike. Kami ipat. Switch mo.
What's in the grape juice?
Huh? You don't come.
Green things so refreshing.
stand up. Ayun, praise namin, Panginoon, and the beauty that you.